In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you why I stopped smoking weed or marijuana, how I did it, and how it's absolutely transformed my life since I've done so. Welcome back to another video. My name is Aaron and I help people expand their consciousness. Now in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the why I quit smoking marijuana and how I did it and how it changed my life and maybe a perspective that you haven't heard before. Now, first off, let me say with this that I quit back in 2012, so it's been a while now, but I feel like I want to make this video because there's a perspective that I have with it that I think is a little bit different than you've heard of other people that may have talked about the same thing, how they used to do it and how they stopped doing it. And first off, let me say, you know, I live in Vegas, it's legal here, it's legal, becoming more and more legal other places. I'm not in any way saying that weed is bad or marijuana is bad. The question is not whether it's bad or good. I think the question is it efficient and does it work for you? Because for a long time, I was smoking, and just to give you a little bit of a background on it, I used to have what is called ADHD, which means I was taking Adderall so that I could focus, which would like really help me focus, but the side effects of Adderall were I couldn't eat very much and I couldn't sleep very much. So I took Adderall for years. I worked a sales commission job at the time, selling women's shoes. And I remember I would take that during the day at work. I'd be very focused, I would make a lot of money. And then I would go home and at the end of the night, it would have trouble sleeping and I have trouble eating. Well, what takes care of that? Well, weed is something that when you do, it enhances your appetite and it also enhances being able to sleep good. So what I would do is during the day I would take Adderall, I would make money at work selling women's shoes at Nordstrom's here in Las Vegas, and I would come home at night, and then what I would do is I would smoke so that I could kind of wind down and get to a place to where I could eat and I could sleep. And I did that for probably a year and a half, 2 years, very consistently. And it worked at the time. However, one of the things I realized was that I felt like I was dependent on it. I was dependent on both the Adderall and that of the weed. And I remember just starting to get little signs. It was almost like little signs that there was other ways to go about this. And there was other ways that I could balance out my energy. And I remember I actually came across and found a research article on meditation and the powerful effects of meditation, how meditation can balance out the hormones. And I was like, oh, that's cool, because if Adderall is making me feel more dopamine, but then I'm crashing and I don't feel as good, and meditation is something I can do that I can balance myself out and there's only positive side effects, then why wouldn't I try that? So the idea was I'm gonna try meditation. So what I did is I started meditating, and at first I thought it was kind of annoying to meditate. I remember sitting down and staring. What I did is I stared at a candle flame, because I read that somewhere. If you stare at a candle flame, it keeps the eyes focused on one point. And when your eyes are focused on one point, your eyes aren't moving around. If you've ever heard that saying that when your eyes wander, your mind wanders, it's like every time your eyes shift, you have a new point of stimulus. So if you keep it focused on one point, it becomes much easier to focus. So what I did is I focused on that candle flame, that one point. And in the first day or two that I decided to learn meditation, there wasn't a huge difference because I was still trying to control my mind. I was like, can't think negative thoughts. This is also shortly after I learned that of The Secret and the power of it. I was really starting to apply it in my life, which is like the law of attraction. So when I was thinking negative thoughts, I was like, can't think negative thoughts. I was trying to block them out because I didn't want to manifest something bad. But what I did is, by the third day, I read somewhere and I just had this feeling that if I would just observe my thoughts and allow them to be there, that would change a lot, that I would get a completely different result. And I remember that I made this choice that I sat down and it was kind of like this unconscious choice I made that I said, I know my life is going to change forever from learning this and doing this meditation. I just had this feeling about it. So what I did is I sat down and I stared at the candle flame and I observed my thoughts. And I started to detach. I started to detach from the thoughts. I started to see them as thoughts rather than as me. I started to observe my ego in a new way. And as I did that, I started to relate to myself in a new way. And then I saw how a lot of the thoughts I had are just on recycle. They're just recycled over and over again. And from that, it was like I could see these thoughts come in and I could see them leave. I could see them come in and leave. And I was allowing them to be there. But the more I did that, the more I began to feel better. The more like my vibration began to raise. And I began to feel high naturally because I wasn't smoking when I was doing that meditation. And It was just this feeling that began to elevate within me. And over the course of like another couple days of doing it, I started to feel like a completely new person simply because I was observing my thoughts rather than reacting to them. Now, this is when my life really began to change. I remember that I went back and forth for a while with weed because what I did is my mind still wanted it. So I remember that I have good friends here in Vegas that own like the best smoke shop here in Vegas. And I used to go in there and get pieces and stuff. And I remember one time I got a bong and I brought it home and I knew I should have already quit. Like I knew that I already decided to, and I felt kind of guilty about getting it because I knew I was going in a new direction, but I bought like this really nice bong. I remember I took one hit out of it and I knew that was the last hit I was ever going to take. And when I took that hit, it was like I knew it as I was hitting it that was going to be the last hit I ever took. And in the moment that I realized that, it was the only hit I ever took out of that bong, I started to cry. And I was crying, and as I was crying, I was letting go of all the past emotion that I felt from smoking weed so consistently, because I was using it as a crutch, because I had a painful childhood growing up, I had an abusive ex-stepmom, and I had all these emotions that were kind of suppressed, so I would do that, and that would kind of help me to like numb that pain or that remembrance of those thoughts. And when I was going through that, and I was crying, I was bringing up these emotions from the past of remembering how I made people feel when I was doing it, because I used to go to my dad's house a lot. Not that I'm not saying that there's really anything bad about this, but in general, I felt guilty because I'd go over to my dad's house and I would hang out with like the family and stuff, but I would be, you know, I would kind of be there but not be there in a way. And I knew he knew that, so I kind of felt his emotion of what he felt, and I felt emotions of other people's in my life that felt like the residual of me doing it and kind of always being in that state. And I felt this release of energy flush through me, and it was like I was releasing it. And after that, I never had a desire to do it again. And I was able to then just meditate, and then my vibration began to raise. And I want to share with you this chart of consciousness right here, just to show you that once you raise your vibration to a certain point, smoking weed or even drinking will bring your vibration down, because your natural vibration is to be in a high vibrational state. I would say that on a scale of 1 to 10, I normally felt like I was at about a 3 to a 5 out of 10, with 10 feeling amazing, 1 feeling not so great. After I learned meditation, and after I went through what's called a spiritual awakening, where I realized that I'm not my ego, I'm not just my thoughts, there's more than that, I went to like a 7 or 8 out of 10. I started to feel really, really good. So because I was feeling really good, anytime I would do anything like smoke weed or drink, it would bring my vibration down. So I was like, why am I doing this? So eventually, I just completely got rid of it. So that was something that changed my life, is learning how to raise my vibration. And once you raise your vibration, you don't need anything else. Not saying this to brag, but I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't drink caffeine. I have a lot of it. You may notice in my videos, I have a lot of energy. I have a lot of energy all the time. It's our natural state. If you feed your body good food, if you are doing that of what you love, especially, I make videos, I do what I love, then I'm in a high vibrational state majority of the time. And that, I believe, is our natural state of being. Now, I want to show you this chart right here, just to show you the chart of consciousness that I share in many videos, because these are different calibrations on this. So you'll see at the bottom, shame, fear, guilt. And then you'll see a powerful step is neutrality, when we learn how to observe our thoughts. That's what I started to do, was to observe my thoughts, and then my vibration began to raise above that. And then what happens is you get that to acceptance, willingness, acceptance, and then you'll see that of reasoning, love, joy, peace, enlightenment. Now, this is the scale of consciousness that is from a book called Power Versus Force. Now, these states of emotion have different calibrations, and based on these calibrations, you can calibrate things using muscle testing. That's what the book Power Versus Force talks about, to identify truth or falsehood, and to also calibrate different things. So there's certain activities that vibrate at a certain calibration. Now let me share that of a couple calibrations, just so you get a feel for this. Einstein calibrated at 499, because that's reasoning, that's the intellect. He took it as far as you could possibly go, and in order to get to love, he would have had to let go of that intellect. So that's reasoning. He was at 499. If you look at certain other things, they'll calibrate at a certain frequency. Now, alcohol calibrates at about 275. So you see, 275 on the scale isn't necessarily high. And when people do it, they may feel relief if they're in the lower emotions, and then they drink, they may feel a little bit better. However, then you see that of acceptance. Now, weed calibrates at about 340 to 370, which is right at acceptance. Now, it's a funny thing, because when you smoke, what kind of state do you get in? You kind of accept the moment as it is. You're kind of like, oh, it's all good. You're more just in that state of allowing. Now, the thing is for a lot of people, maybe if you're in the lower states or you're feeling a certain way and you do it, you will get a pick-me-up. You will feel better. But the thing is when you raise your vibration to a higher state of consciousness, then you are above that. So when you do those things, it then brings you down. You may be at reasoning and then bringing yourself down to acceptance. Or you may be at acceptance and bringing yourself down to drinking. If you drink, you may bring you down even more to pride. You know, it's funny because drinking is close to courage, but courage still has a little bit of pride in it. But why do they call it liquid courage? You see? So it's kind of an interesting idea. But as you look at the scale right here, what you'll notice is there's different calibrations. Now, when you raise your vibration by observing your thoughts, not attaching to the ego, in reasoning, it's about understanding that you realize your beliefs create your reality. You start to let go of all of the things that power, anything that has power over you. And you start to realize things and you start to relate to life in a different way. As you raise your frequency, you will then resonate with new people. You will then resonate with new opportunities in your life. So what I would say to anyone that is smoking weed is, first off, I'm not telling you it's bad. I'm not telling you to even stop. I'm saying just be honest with yourself, because the last thing you want to hear is somebody telling you, when you smoke especially, it's almost like you want to block out anybody saying anything different. That was me. I would come across an article and I wouldn't want to read it because I didn't want it to interfere with me enjoying the process of, or the activity of smoking. However, just see if this resonates with you. Maybe instead, you move and you focus on raising your vibration, and by doing so, you'll find that some things just don't resonate anymore. Everything is within you to feel joy, love, and peace. That's within you. And if you do the inner work, you will actually raise your vibration more. I think a lot of people hold themselves back with smoking weed because, like Alan Watts said, once you get the message on the phone, once you get the message, hang up the phone. But sometimes what we do is we get the message and we just keep listening and keep listening and keep listening when we already got the message and we can move on. And I see a lot of people that I think have even more potential of what they could accomplish, and some people justify it and they'll say, oh, well, when I smoke, I'm more creative, I'm more this. I think that the most potent energy we have is within us, and when we align it to what we want and we have a desire, or at least we align with it vibrationally, we'll create what we want in our life. But the best way to focus with that is through our own energy. And we don't need anything else other than that. Now, I'm not saying to never do it. I'm just saying to be honest with yourself and to see, is it really sufficient for you? Is it really serving you? Because if it is serving you, then I think that's great. But be honest with doing it and whether you can make the transition and maybe let it go. I have a feeling that a lot of you reading or watching this right now, if you were to let it go, I have a feeling you would and will raise your vibration, because right now on the planet, it is a time of raising our vibe. And as you raise your vibe, you're going to resonate with new things in your life, and it may actually be holding you back in many ways, even just unconsciously without you even knowing it. And when you do that, know that, yes, there might be a week or two period that feels a little bit weird if you do it a lot. I remember when I quit, there was a little bit of a weird feeling for a week or two, but guess what? It eventually went away, and my natural state of being was who I am. So what I'd say is, if you quit, use meditation as something that will help you do it. Observe your thoughts. Supplement it with something that's very positive. And doing so, you'll begin to raise your vibration. As you raise your vibration up the scale of consciousness, you'll realize that you don't need to smoke. You don't need to even drink. You can just feel good and high all of the time. Being high is your natural state of being. And I believe that the more you look into that, and the more that you realize that, the more you're going to be able to embody who you really are. So with that being said, I also will be doing more live Q&As on Instagram, so if you want to ask me questions about this, if you want me to make a follow-up video as to exactly how to do it rather than just supplementing it with meditation, you want more information on that, leave a comment below. Let me know what you think of this video. Is this something that resonates with you? Is this a video that maybe will help you to let go of it and start to be in your own high vibrational state? Let me know what you think below. And also, yeah, daily live Q&As on Instagram. You'll see me there. I post twice a day there as well. Other than that, I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to like this video if you liked it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the little notification gear next to the subscribe button so you can see the daily vids that I do. And other than that, as always, peace, much love, and namaste.